My name is Mary Lynn Lawrence. I'm the Vice President of Professional Services at Advanced Marketplace. And I'm going to take the opportunity today to do a demonstration of the Advanced Marketplace Facilities mApp. There are a couple of components that I wanted to highlight here. We're just going to have one slide and then jump into the demo. But we're going to hit three different areas of the mApp that make up the overall facilities functionality. The first piece is the portal. And the portal is really important from an end user perspective. It can be configured to have your corporate theme, your corporate colors, and it can be the one place that end users can go to get requests and issues recorded and track the status. We're going to hit project. Project tracking is an overlay that allows you to track projects from initiation through implementation and closure. It tracks all of the different areas that you'd expect to have covered within a project, like project members, meeting minutes, cost items, budget, deliverables. And we're going to talk about how that's related to work orders. And the core, the heart of the mApp, is the work order area. We're going to go into a work order and show you the key components that are around tracking building and people information, categorizing the work orders, tracking time and materials, get a view of the project if there is one associated with it, and also have the ability to set up scheduled maintenance. So let me go into the demo right now, and we're going to start, as I said, with the portal. So what you see here is the Advanced Marketplace Hub, and this is a representation of an enterprise service management model. We're going to go into the facilities area, but what I do want to highlight is that in this type of a model, the end user comes to one place to find out information about tickets that they've reported and be able to get resources and requests from different areas in the corporation. So in this case, we allow end users to access human resources areas, IT, as well as facilities. And one of the core points of this is the My Items ticket area. And I want to take you in there for just a second. And I want to show you that as Tracy, an end user, I can see the status of the tickets that I've reported that are IT-related types of issues and also the work orders, all from one portal. Let's go and take a look at the facilities area of the portal. Now, what we've done here, underlying the back end, just like in Cherwell in general, is the service catalog. But what we've done is pulled that service catalog out to a higher level view. And we've taken a survey of other facility implementations that we've done, and we identified these four areas as being they account for about 75% of the issues and requests reported in the facilities area. We also have the ability to go out and look into other areas of facility if these areas don't fit exactly what you're looking for. We have a facilities announcement area. This is segmented from the other HR and IT announcements, so even announcements is set up in a multi-tenant mode. You can also view open work orders. So the view of open work orders is really important because about a third of the calls into any service desk are related to status. So what we've done is we've exposed a lot of information about the work orders to the end user. So in this case, I know that Sawyer owns the ticket. I know the team that owns the ticket. This is the information that I put in. I can see the task that is being worked to this work order. I can see who is assigned to. And in this case, I have it associated to a project. So even from an end user perspective, I can get a little bit of a view of the project that's associated with some of the work orders. So let me take you back, and let's go in and let me show you how easy it is to report an issue. I'm going to report a plumbing issue. We're just asking for description, issue with leaky toilet. Capture the all-important building name, floor information if it's available, and then just go ahead and submit the ticket. And when I submit the ticket, this will go in and create a work order. And that work order will then be visible in my queue as well. One final area that I would like to show you on the work order portal side is the ability to use the powerful catalog within Cherwell to get deeper into other types of facility issues or requests. So I click on the other facility request area, and it brings me into a subset of the overall service catalog. So I can put additional entries out here that people can drill through and open up requests for as well. So now I'd like to go ahead and take you over into the actual technician view of the work order and project. When we come into the dashboard, you see that it is a dashboard that's configured with a facilities look and feel, or at least a view. Building is very important in the facilities world, so we have lots of things that are showing the building available in reports. We show the different work by groups, the status of those, and really important areas are the owned by tickets, the work orders owned by my team, and the work orders owned by the tasks that are owned by my team. I'm going to go ahead and view one of these work orders so we can go in and take a look at some of the critical components of it. So in this work order, you have the general information that you'd expect, recording the information. We have a classification for facilities types of issues. So you can see that we've got a service of facilities, we've got the categories and subcategories to help get down into the types of information that needs to be collected and good reporting. One of the areas here I want to show you is work order type. This one happens to be scheduled maintenance. Now I'll show you the other ones because a lot of them are just break fix or customer requests. When scheduled maintenance is selected, you would click on tasks that you potentially want to have created. And in this case, I have a quarterly schedule with three tasks. And I'll show those to you in the task area as well. We capture the building information. You can capture start and end dates and additional information. We have the requester. We have the owned by team. So you can have this assigned to facilities and then break down those assignments to facilities by building if that works for you. Another key area of the work order is the ability to track time and track costs. So as things are recorded against the work order, and if additional time needs to be reported or costs need to be reported, it's as easy as a click, order supplies as an example. And you put the dollar value in here. I'm going to make it $120. And so my cost was incremented, and all of these things are tracked as tasks and can be reported on later. So looking at tasks, you can see there are several different types of tasks. I've got an order for cleaning. Sawyer Watson has to order supplies for cleaning. And I also see the future tasks that have already been scheduled based on the scheduled maintenance. These are not shown out on the to-do queue or your work queue unless they're within 30 days of the due date. So they're visible in here, but only visible in the work queue when it's pertinent. You see task generation was completed, and there is a workflow in the work order, record, classify, execution, and completion. So I have a project that's related to this work order, so we're going to go into the project area next. So we go view my projects, and I will just pick the parking lot ongoing maintenance, and we'll talk about the different areas of the project as well. When we first started meeting with facility organizations, we didn't realize project was going to be a key component for them, but more and more facility organizations want to be able to track important projects, the associated budgets, against the different types of areas that they need to expend on. So in this case, we have capital improvement, renew and refresh, and ongoing maintenance. In the project, you have a workflow, you have somebody who requested it, and you have a project manager. You have cost, you have your budget, and you have a little bit of a traffic light kind of reference up in the corner that tells you when these different areas are green, yellow, or red. The areas that you can track in the project include deliverables, cost items, and cost items are really important because you're able to add them up and debit them against the budget in order to get the health of that. So in this case, I have a labor one and I have a tool one. Project members are evaluated and kept in with the project. You can identify risk and issues, meeting minutes, tasks, journals, lots of different really important areas of a project. But for the facilities map, what's important is the ability to track work orders against that project. So either the project manager, while they're working in the project, can open a new work order, or if you're in a work order and you know you need to associate it back to an ongoing maintenance project, you can create that link back to the project. So those are the key areas of the facilities MApp that I wanted to hit: the portal, the work order, and the project.